this class is a combination of art history and chemistry. What the students gain is an appreciation for the discipline that they're less familiar with.
But we take a look at how chemists work in a conservation lab at a museum in order to analyze pigments and grounds and surfaces. And then we looked at how art historians put that material together in order to analyze what a painting might mean, how to interpret it.
Several of our students are biology or chemistry majors and haven't taken much in the art department, and so they get an experience from Patricia about the art history and about ways of looking at art from the art perspective. And I think the art students or the classics major, for instance, gets a look at the science and gets to see that maybe science isn't unreachable or unattainable.
You know, I'm working mostly with really ancient stuff, mostly as a classical studies major, and like going through this sort of art and chemistry course and showing me how the degradation of color works is giving me a little bit more perspective on something that I'm very familiar with.
What we're trying to do is to show the students that each of the disciplines has a reach into the other disciplines, that they're not just always single disciplines on their own.
For me, in a certain way, there's really no going back. It seems to me that it is the best possible educational experience.